Hello viewers, good afternoon. I'm here to bless you all with the word of God. Praise the Lord. Happy Good Friday to everyone. May the peace of the Most High God be with you all in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm here to bless you with a word that says, righteous of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let's see what the Lord says about the righteous of the Lord. May the peace of the Most High God be with you all in the powerful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let's take a look at Romans 8 verse 4. I read, it says that the righteous of the Lord may be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Praise the Lord. Righteous of the Lord. Praise Master Jesus, as the Lord told us here. Here I'm going to talk of the law. Praise the Lord. Of the law, it says that who walk after the flesh. And the second one is after the Spirit. Praise Master Jesus. So we are still going to take a look at Galatians 6 verse 8. Let's see what the Lord said about the flesh. He said, for him that sowed to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that sowed to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. Praise the Lord. He that sowed to the flesh is telling us here that he that sowed to the flesh, he reaped corruption. He that sowed to the Spirit, he reaped life. Praise the Lord. He reaped everlasting life. Praise the Lord. Eternal life that the Lord God that cannot lie, that promised us for the beginning. Praise Master Jesus. Today, the Lord has died for us. He has died for us on the cross of Calvary so that we can have this eternal life. Praise Master Jesus. Whatsoever that you find yourself in life, that the devil that used to tie you down, that devil that used to have power over you, today heaven has destroyed that yoke in the powerful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Almighty God has destroyed that yoke. He has died for us. He has taken away that pain in our life today in the powerful name of Jesus. So let's see what the Lord told us about the flesh. Let's take a look at the same Galatians 5 verse 19. Let's see what the Lord told us, explain about the life of the flesh. Praise Master Jesus. I read, he said there, Galatians 5 verse 19. So we are going to read to 22. Let's see what the Almighty God explained to us about the life of the flesh. Praise Master Jesus. Praise the Lord. So, I read, he said, now the work of the flesh, are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness. And verse 20, I read, it says, adultery, witchcraft, hatred, immolation, what? Stab, sodination, heresy. Praise the Lord. 21, he says, heaviness, murderers, drunkenness, revenge, and such. Like of the which I told you before, as I have also told you in time past, that those who do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Praise the Lord. Who do all these things? Who practice all these things? We not inherit the kingdom of God, because all these things is the work of the flesh. Praise the Lord. All this thing is the work of prayer. Jesus has died for us so that we can be able to have that opportunity, to have that chance to close to God, to have that chance to repent. That is the remains of death that Jesus has died for you and I today, to repent for sin, to repent. Come to God. He will accept you. Come to Him. He will forgive you. Come to Him. He will forgive you. Take that garment of darkness away from you and wear you the garment of life. Oh, Jesus has died for you today. Jesus come for us and died for us. He did not come to die for the righteous. Jesus come to die for the sinner. For the sinner to repent. Praise the Lord. For the sinner to repent. Praise the Lord. Come to Him whatsoever you find yourself in this world. Come to Him. He will forgive you. He will take that coat away from you. Wear you a coat of righteousness, of everlasting, in the powerful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So we are still going to take a look at the 20:22. The same Galatians say, let's see what the Lord also told us, says here. He said, but the fruit of the Spirit is love. Praise the Lord. The fruit of the Spirit is love. Praise Master Jesus. He said, it's love, joy, peace, long suffering, gentleness, goodness, and faith. Praise the Lord. This is the love of the flesh. Praise Master Jesus. I know that in some time in life, we can be able not to be patient, to wait for the time of the Lord, that the Lord said that He will fulfill whatsoever that we ask for Him. Come to Him with the heavy laden, and Almighty God will give you rest. He will give you rest. He has died for you today. He has died for you today so that you can be able to have that chance. Praise Master Jesus. You can be able to have that chance to walk over your salvation so that you can be able to reach that eternal life, that God has no life, that promised the world before the world began. Praise Master Jesus. So let's see what the Lord also says in Philippians. Praise Master Jesus. Philippians 3 verse 21. I read. He said, who shall change your vain body that it may be fashioned like unto His glorious body, according to the work whereby He is able even to subdue all things Himself. Praise the Lord. Is Jesus Christ of Nazareth can change that your vain body. Praise Master Jesus. Is Jesus Christ. Is what He did for me and you today. Is what He did for you today. Is what He did for you today. For you to have that chance. For you to have that chance for repentance. Praise the Lord. The Lord also loved the world that He gave this only begotten Son. And He gave His life for you today on the cross of Calvary to receive that pain. That humiliation, even the death of cross, the death of cross, both that humiliation, God, Jesus has taken it for you today so that you can have eternal life, so that you can have that relationship with God, so that you can be able to close to your Father. Praise Master Jesus. Why are you still in on those lives? Renounce all those lives and come to Jesus. Renounce all those lives and come to Jesus. Jesus can be able to change that your face body. His Almighty God is able to change it for you. Run to Him today. Run to Him today. He has died for you on the cross of Calvary. He has died for you today on the cross of Calvary that shed that blood for you. He has shed that blood for you. For you to be able to have that chance. For you to be able to have that eternal life. For you to be able to live the righteous life. For you to be able to have that glorious destiny. For you able to live a victorious life in Christ Jesus. Walk over your salvation. Walk over your salvation. Walk in the life of the Spirit. Because the Bible also tells us that the same day. Let's see what the Lord also tells us in Romans. God stayed us in Romans 8 verse 1. I read. He says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus. who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. No condemnation for them that in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is calling you today. Almighty God is calling you today. Come to him with that heavy ladder that in you. He will drop it away for you. He will make a way for you. He will change that your vain body and give your glorious body to be fashionable. Hallelujah. Parabazondorebaba. Yes. Almighty God is telling you today. Come to him. He will take away all this problem away for you in the powerful name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So let's also take a look at what the Lord also is telling us about this work of the flesh. Let's see what the Lord says here. The same Philippians, let's see what the Lord says. Philippians 3 verse 9. Praise the Lord. Thank you so much, Lord Jesus. Thank you so much, Lord Jesus. Thank you so much, Lord Jesus. I thank you, I thank you, I thank you. Oh, I say, oh, we come to say thank you. I say, no, never bow. Oh, say, what say, oh, read the report, man, well. Have an oracle, say, read the rule, man, well. Have an oracle, say. Oh, I say, oh, I come to say thank you, Baba. I say, no, 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 Abba, no repete. Oh, Father, we thank you. We glorify your name. Blessed be your name, O Lord, God of universe. Thank you, Jesus. So, I read Philippians 2, verse 9. He said, wherefore, God also highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. As he died for us today, as he died for you and I today to live a victorious life, God also gave him a name which above every other name. Above whatsoever forces on darkness of the world, whatsoever name they call themselves, God has given name, that name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Aye, Baba. That name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That name, at the name of the Lord, every name must bow. Let's see what the Lord says. Let's read verse 10. He said that at the name of Jesus, every name should bow. At the name of the Lord, every name, aye, Baba, must bow to that name of Jesus, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. Praise Master Jesus. That verse 11, I read, it says, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord, to the glory of the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Every tongue will confess. Oh, confess your sin. Confess your sin to the Lord. He is able to forgive you your sin. Forgive you. He is able to forgive your sin. Confess your sin. Confess your sin. Today he died for you on the cross of Calvary so that you can be able to confess your sin. He will forgive you. Confess your sin. He's able to accept you. He's accept you. Come to him. Come to him. Remove that garment of shame. Remove that garment of secret criteria. Remove that garment of pain. Come to live a victorious life in Jesus' name, in Jesus' family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Come unto him. Today he has died for you on the dead of cross, for you to be able to have that chance to come to the Almighty God, for you to receive your heavenly destiny in Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. So let's see what he's still saying here. That is verse 12. He said, wherefore my beloved, as you have always obeyed not as in my present only, but now much more in my outside work, out of your salvation. with fear, with fear. Walk over your salvation with fear. Praise the Lord. Walk over your salvation with fear. Walk over your salvation with fear. Praise the Lord. Walk over your salvation. Over your salvation with fear. Praise the Lord. For you to have that eternal life. He died for us today on the cross of Calvary so that we can have that heaven-able destiny. Praise Master Jesus, inscribe Jesus. Father, thank you for the life that you give us. Thank you, Lord my God, for the life that you give us. Blessed be your name, King of glory, the El Shaddai, the I am that I am. We give you all the praise. Blessed be your name, my Redeemer liveth, in Jesus' mighty name. So let's see what here says to us now. He said to us here, three verse, this three night that said that of the righteousness. Let's see what the Lord also says. Let's see what the Lord says about the spirit. Praise Master Jesus. Let's see what the Lord tells us about the life of the spirit. May God Almighty bless the world in Jesus' name. Be blessed, because I'm going to stop here now. I will make it to other videos. Praise the Lord. I also put it in the same way you can be able to understand. So I'm going to also explain how the Lord says about the law of the Spirit. May the peace of the Most High God be with you all in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever the Satan has bound you, whatsoever.